Welcome to Iga Online TV. Today we are going to talk about how to format text in Word, in Microsoft Word. To show you how to format text in Word, we'll walk through formatting a completely unformatted business documents file or any other documents. For example, the following documents looks boring and formatted. So how can you make it beautiful? How can you format it for an easy reading and an easy reporting? Formatting text in Word refers to controlling how text appears in your document. This includes the size, color, and the font of the text. It also covers text alignment, spacing, and letter cases. Let's start with learning how to apply typographic emphasis. For starters, for beginners, let's use typographic emphasis like bolding, italicizing, or underlining to make the report title stand out. To do this, select the text you want to emphasize. You click on the bold button on the Microsoft Word ribbon. You see that the text is bolded or is emphasized. Note that the ribbon also has the buttons to apply italics, underline, strike through, and other formatting effects for the text. You can follow the same steps to apply those effects. Let's apply italics. You also apply underline. You also apply strike through and other formatting effects. As I said, you follow the same steps. You select the text you want to emphasize. You click on the italics, or you click on I to apply italics. You can click on U to apply underline or to underline the text. You can click on strike through to underline the text but through it, passing through the text. So let's now change the font and the font size and even the color of the title. You can even change the font, the size, and the color of the other content of the text. Again, you select the text. You click the drop down allow on the font section of the ribbon. Then you select the font you want to apply. For example, you can choose Arial Bold. You can choose the New Times Roman. You can choose Algerian. You can choose whatever font style that you want. After applying the font style, you see that the style or the way the text looks like changes immediately. After, let's change the font size. To change the font size, you highlight the text or you select it. You click the drop down arrow on the font size indicator on the ribbon as shown in the video, and then you click on the font size of your choice. You can choose 10, 12, 16, 20, 24, whatever size that you want. You can apply it to your text. After selecting this font size, you see that the size of the text changes immediately. You can make your text bigger or smaller the way you want. Or after highlighting the text, you can type the font size into the font style, the font size indicator on the ribbon. This it is especially useful when the font size you want is not available in the font size selector. If you want what is not available on the selector of the font size, you can type it instead of say, choosing or selecting it. Okay, I think I've seen it. So let's move on. You can also use the increase font size or decrease font size buttons on the ribbon to quickly change the font size. Instead of selecting the font size, you can use these two buttons. The first one is increase font size, another one is decrease font size. You see, it is the capital A and the small A. When you click on these two buttons, the capital A and the small A, you are choosing to increase the font size or you are choosing to decrease the font size. Instead of selecting it, you can use these two methods. We can easily change the font color as well. We have emphasized using bold, italics, and underline. We have changed the font style. We have also changed the font size. We can also change the color of the text that you have typed in Microsoft Word. First of all, you highlight the text. Whatever you do before you format the text, you have to highlight it or to select it. After highlighting the text, you click the down arrow beside the font color selector. You click on the color of your choice. You can also choose more colors if you wish to apply a custom color. Maybe the colors which are provided here, which are like default, you don't want them. You can use more colors to apply a custom color as follows. You see that your text is looking more beautiful than before when we were starting the text formatting. You can continue applying the font color to different words in the text. On one word you can choose red, another word you choose pink, and so on. So the first part of our lesson was how to apply typographic emphasize. That is just changing or bolding, italicizing, or underlining the text. The second one was changing the font, the font size, and the color of the title or the color of the main text or the text that you have typed in Microsoft Word. So let's move on that second part. The second part is how to change capitalization in Word. We've said that formatting the text in Microsoft Word means what? Formatting the text in Microsoft Word is just controlling how the text appears in your document. So now when we change emphasize, we are controlling how the text looks like. But on the second part, we are going now to change capitalization. We write words in small letters or in capital letters. Microsoft Word also allows you to easily and quickly change the capitalization of your text. For example, if you want to make the title all uppercase, we don't have to retype it to clean it or to delete it, and then we start typing again. You can easily or quickly change the capitalization of your text. First of all, highlight the title, or you highlight the text that you want, and then click the change case button on the ribbon. You see, this is the change case button on the ribbon. Or you highlight the text and you go to format, change case. There are two ways. First of all, you change case button. You click on change case button on the ribbon. When you click there, you see there is sentence case, lower case, upper case, capitalize each word, and toggle case. When you click on, when you select sentence case, the text looks like a sentence, a normal sentence. When you click on lower case, all letters are written in small letters. When you choose uppercase, all letters of the text is capitalized. When you choose capitalize each word, all words in the text is capitalized. The first letter of the word is capitalized. When you choose toggle case, the first letter of each word is written in small letter, but other letters are written in capital letters. As we said, we can also use the format and you change case. You go to format on the tab, you click on the format tab, and then you click on change case. After clicking on the change case, you can change the case the way you want. You capitalize or you write the words in small letters. You can also use toggle or the sentence case and so on. You then click on the radio button for the case you want to apply. You click OK. You see that here you have the sentence case, the lower case, the upper case, capitalize each word, and you can also choose toggle case, and then you click on OK. So you see that these two methods are the same. So it's up to you to choose what is the simplest way to capitalize your text. Now you see now the text is looking much better. It is the most prominent part of the document, and the commands that you apply on the text helps the readers to be attentive or to be at the text looks attractive for the readers to read it. So if you don't format the text, the readers won't be attracted to your text. So that is why we have to format the text beautifully in a way that readers will easily be able to read the text. Three, let's now talk about how to format paragraphs. One way to make your documents easier to read is by increasing white space around lines and paragraphs. You can increase the space between the lines, the space between the paragraph for the easy reading. So one, to adjust the line spacing, adjust line spacing. Let it make it clear. It is to adjust line spacing. It is the space between the two lines. You select the text. You click on the arrow on the line and the paragraph spacing. You click on the line and paragraph spacing button. And then you select the line spacing you wish to apply. You can choose 1.0, you can choose 1.15, you can choose 1.5, you can choose 2.0, 2.5, 3.0. You can also customize line spacing options, but here the default one is 1.0, and what is most used is 1.5. but depending on how you wish your text to look like, you choose the line spacing that you want, and after you select one, and then you see immediately that the space between the lines increases. You can decrease it or you can increase it. When you decrease it, it will be more difficult for readers to read it, but when you increase the size between the lines, it will be very easy for them to read it. That is why we have to format our text to make easy, to make it easier for readers to read it. Second, let's change the spacing around a paragraph. How do we change the spacing around a paragraph? You select the paragraph. Remember that the paragraph is a set of lines, and you click on the arrow on the line and the paragraph spacing button, and then you click on line spacing options. You then type the amount of spacing before and after the paragraph. Remember, we are just adjusting the spacing between the paragraph. Now you are choosing the spacing before and after the paragraph. You can adjust other settings from the dialog box as well. So for the title, I will add a generous amount of spacing after the paragraph to set it apart from the rest of the document, because the title is the main, it's just the, it comprises the content of the text. That is why you set it apart to make it separated from the other content of the text. But all of them, paragraphs by paragraphs, you can change the spacing between those paragraphs. You choose the spacing before the paragraph or the spacing after the paragraph. Remember that here we are typing the amount of spacing that we want. You can also customize it, or you can adjust other settings from the dialog box, as we said before. 3. Finally, let's change the alignment of the title. When you say alignment, means what? Where do you start typing your text? Are you aligning center, aligning left, or aligning right? Or you are just adjusting? So select the text. You click on either the align left. When you click on align left, you see that the text is aligned from left. Align center or center text, you see that the text is aligned center. You normally start typing from the center of the page, of the paper. You can also align right. The text is aligned from right. Or you justify. Okay, when you justify, you are starting from left, from right, and ending to the left. You see that there is no gap left in the margin, just between the text and the margin. That is justifying. You click on justifying button, the ribbon, to justify the text. So for the title, it is better use the center text for it to be clear from other content of the text, because here we have the title. But for the other text, it is better you start from you align right, and you can also justify to make it very beautiful. This simple formatting effects make the text stand out from the unformatted text. We are formatting the text to make it, or we are controlling it for the reader to be able to read it easy. Because when you change the color, when a reader is reading, the reader will focus on the words which are colored. The reader will focus on the words which are underlined, which are bold, which are italicized, or which are underlined using this strike through. That is why here we are formatting the text to make it very, very looks beautiful for readers to read it. 4. How to work with Microsoft Word style. We are going now to use the styles. Remember that here we are formatting the text. We are not limiting our format. We are just formatting all the text. We are applying all the formatting commands. We are not limiting on bolding, on italicizing, on underlining. We are just deeply explaining how you can format your text. So let's now on fourth. Let's look how we can work with the Microsoft Word styles. As much as Word makes it easy to format text, if you need to apply formatting effects on the entire document, the process becomes tedious. Word solves that through styles. Here we were focusing on the title and some other words, but here the Microsoft Word styles allow you to define a set of formatting commands and apply them automatically to every item in the document with that style. You set or you customize the style that you want to use, and the Word will be inserting that style that you have customized before in the documents from where you want it applied. Let's look at a specific example. How to modify a paragraph style. Let's follow the steps above to define a style for the main headings of the report with the following characteristics. You follow, we have some characteristics that you have to set so that the paragraph, that the style, we want to set a style for the main headings of the report or the text or the document. So first of all, we want the font, which is Arial. We want the size, which is 14. We want the color, which is you can choose black, or you can also choose red. Typographic info size, we choose bold. Case, we choose capitalize each word. Alignment, we choose left. Line spacing, we are choosing single. Paragraph spacing, we choose 6 before paragraph and 0 after paragraph. Let's set it. The first one, we choose the font. After, we choose the size and then the color and then the typographic info size is just bold. Case, we choose capitalize each word. Alignment, we choose left, and the line spacing, we choose single. And paragraph spacing, we choose 6 before paragraph and 0 after paragraph. So what you have set would look like this. As you see, it looks like this. Okay, now we can use this one. When you click on this style that you have set, you see that the headings that you have selected takes that style that you want. Here we are modifying a paragraph style. We are working with the style, but we are modifying the paragraph style. The paragraph style there, but you can modify it. You make it the way you want. So when you click on this style that you have modified, all the text which is highlighted will apply that style on the text that you highlight. That is why here we are calling it modifying a paragraph style. One way to apply this exact formatting on every main heading is to modify the existing heading 1. Here we are having main headings, heading 1, heading 2. You can just modify existing heading 1 style in our documents here. That is what I've made. I've just modified the heading. You press your cursor anywhere in the main headings, and then you go to styles, right click on the heading, you then choose update heading one too much selection. That is what you have done. Yeah, here I'm just summarizing the process. You go to style, you right click on the heading, and then you choose update headings one to match selection. You can also modify any style by going to format. You see there is format here. You select, you choose style, and then the style dialog box opens. You select the style you want to modify from the style list, and this gives you a preview of the paragraph and character, as well as a description of the current style state settings of the select style. And then you click on modify. The modify style dialog box pops up. And then you start now modifying. You change the text and the paragraph format settings. Here you can control the font, the font size, the font color, typographic info size, alignment and spacing. And when you are done, you click on OK. So here the text now, the style of the paragraph is modified. Mm-hmm. Second, how to apply a paragraph style? How can you apply a paragraph style? Remember that here we are just talking about all formatting in Microsoft Word. We are not limiting, we are not just cutting it off, we are not close cutting it, but we are just going deep in formatting the text. We can format a single text or just format the paragraph. Second, how do we apply a paragraph style? You now go to each main heading in the document and apply the heading one. You apply heading one style to it. You press the cursor on the heading and you go to style and heading one. You point your cursor on the heading that you want. Remember that the heading is just like the title, and then you click on the heading that you want. The selected text instantly takes on the formatting of heading 1 or heading 2 or heading 3, depending on the kind of heading that you want. Okay, how can you create a list paragraph style? You can also create a new paragraph style from scratch instead of modifying an existing one. To demonstrate, let's create a list type paragraph style. You go to format, you go to style, you fill in the properties selection of the dialog box that opens. You fill in, you complete it. The name, you give the name. The style type, you give the name. Style based on, you choose. And the style for following paragraph, you can choose normal or whatever that to mean. Here, when you choose normal, the paragraph that follows the what you have just modified will just look normal. But if you choose, the next paragraph will look like the way you want. For style based on, you may wish to use one of the pre-existing list styles as a starting point. So to change the formatting options, the box below gives you a preview. When you click, you have a preview of what you want, and then you start now changing the formatting options. As you see, you have the font, the font style, font size, the typographic info size. Yeah, you can also choose the color, you choose the alignment, you choose whatever, and then here you are just creating, you are changing the font option, the formatting options. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we type, we select the fonts, the font color, the font size, the alignment, the line spacing, the paragraph spacing, and so on. You can also add to template. It will, you'll be just using it. You can also add it to quick style list or automatically update it. When you're happy with the settings you've made, you click on OK, and then you see that what you have created, you see how it looks like, and then you see that it is included in the quick style pop-up. So once the bullet style is applied, your list will look like this one. You see the text now has changed because you are applying the paragraph style that you have created. Four, how to use character styles in Microsoft Word. You can also define a style to an individual word or a block of text rather than a paragraph. In the text, I'm going to apply a character style for every URL in the document. Yes, select the text, then go to format styles, format, then styles. From the style dialog, click new. The create new style from formatting dialog opens, and when it opens, you give the new character style a name. For setup, you choose character, then you make the formatting settings you want to apply to this character. Yes, you see now how the character looks like after creating new. As you said, you can modify, but here we are creating new. Note that you can't change alignment and spacing for a character style. Note that the preview box shows you a sneak peek of the text based on the settings you specified. Mm-hmm. Remember that this one you can add to the template or you add to quick style list. You can format, you can do whatever, and then when you are done, you click on OK, and then your text will look the way you want it. To apply the character style, place your cursor in the word or select a set of words, go to format, go to style, you find the character style you wish to apply, and then you click on apply. Yes. To quickly find the Microsoft Word styles you've created, for it, choose user defined styles. Okay. Lastly, on five, let's learn together how to use table styles in Word. Table styles in Word. We can also define a table style to provide a consistent look to the tables in our document. A consistent. To mean it will not change. It is a consistent. So one, create the table, go to insert table, then indicate the number of columns and rows you need in your table. You can always add and remove this letter, this letter. We will have another lesson of creating tables, and then you click on OK. Second, add your text to the table if necessary. You click and drag enough the border lines to adjust the width or a column or the height of a row. Three, to apply a table style, click anywhere on the table, then go to the table design. The table design ribbon appears. Click on the down arrow for the table styles to display the table styles gallery. The table styles gallery appears, and then you click on any style to apply it to your table. When you drag your cursor, you see that the status changes. That change, that is why you want to select one. You have to select one you want. You can expand the table styles gallery again to change existing style. You clear the style. You apply another style. You clear what you have applied, and then you apply another one, or you create your own table style. Okay. Now let's try to go back to from where we started. We have started from the font group, the simple way of formatting the text. After all, you can also highlight the text you want using different colors. You can also clear all the text formatting that you have applied. You clear all, so you are coming back to the normal the default text that you have started with. When you click on this, you clear all the format that you have made. Thank you very much for today's lesson. Today we have learned all formatting all ways of formatting the text. We have started with, as a reminder, we have started with defining what is text formatting, and after that we have started formatting the text. The first one was how to apply typographic emphasis. You emphasize on the characters, you emphasize on the letters, you emphasize on the words and so on. You want them to be emphasized. And then after we have the second part was how to change capitalization in words. We have seen how you can use toggle case, you can use capitalize each word, you can use uppercase or lowercase or sentence case. And then after that we have learned how to format the paragraphs formatting, the spacing between paragraphs and so on. And the fourth one was how to work with Microsoft Word styles. We have learned it. We have also learned how we can create our own style, and then we'll be applying it to headings or to the paragraphs the way you want them. And then we have the last one was in number five. So number five was how to work with tables to format the table, what you call how to use table styles in Word. And then I want you to create your own documents. If you are a businessman, if you are a scholar, if you are a terminal student, or if you are a secretary in a company anywhere, you can just make a beautiful report which will be easier for the readers to read it. Thank you very much, and I invite you to subscribe. You like this video, you can comment, you can also share it to your friends around around the world. You are always welcome here in this platform, because it is a platform that digitizes our learning style. And remember that we learn together and then we achieve together. Thank you very much.